And finally, the Tracy Belitnikoff Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Gracie Elizabeth Keller. She was a typical happy four-year-old, and then one day she was no longer able to hear. She was diagnosed with otosclerosis, exaggerated growth of bone in the inner ear. It is permanent and it is aggressive. The four-year-old was fitted with hearing aids and soon underwent surgery, the first of many. Doctors believed that her hearing loss probably would be complete and suggested her parents enroll her at the Florida School for the Deaf and Blind in St. Augustine. But they wouldn't do it. They kept her in the public school, even though she cried every day in kindergarten. She couldn't hear, she couldn't understand directions, and her teacher was not sympathetic. Her parents sent her to a summer camp for deaf and hard of hearing kids. My mom and I went, and we were shocked at how silent it was, she says. I said, Mom, I'm not a freak. There are other little girls just like me. Camp Sertoma was the first place where she felt she belonged. There were surgeries and more surgeries. In the fifth grade, Gracie won a Tropicana speech contest with the theme, The Three Best Things About Being Hard of Hearing. One of them was her belief that the singer Nick Jonas would someday marry her because Jonas's mother was a sign language interpreter. In the sixth grade, her attempts to play sports were cut short when she developed extreme pain in her joints and muscles. She was diagnosed with juvenile rheumatoid arthritis and inflammatory bowel disease. Another surgery followed. But she does play sports. She's a cheerleader, and her hearing aids constantly get knocked out when she plays basketball. I've always embraced my hearing loss, she says. I have ear moles in crazy colors, and I have sparkles, swirls, and glow in the dark. That's why sometimes people ask her why she has bubble gum in her ear. She says other frequent questions include, are you retarded? And since you're deaf, does that mean you know Braille? And since your name is Kelleher, does that mean you're related to Helen Keller? Despite the constant pain and her hearing disability, Gracie is an academic star and a leader. She was elected class president every year from the ninth grade through the 12th. This year, she is also the Robert F. Monroe Student Body President, president of the Anchor Club, 4 years varsity tennis, most valuable player tennis, 3 years varsity basketball, winning the basketball coaches award, and captain of the varsity cheerleading team. She's also a first degree black belt in Taekwondo. Her high school advisor, Sherry Helms, says Gracie selflessly and compassionately serves others. Her hand is almost always the first to go up. She says Gracie lives with daily pain, but he would never know. In 2014, she won a national writing contest sponsored by Rochester Institute of Technology and the National Technical Institute for the Deaf. Another advisor, Suzanne Johnson, writes, Gracie's integrity, her concern for others, her sincerity and sense of fairness are exemplary. She is willing to do the difficult things that will bring her success and happiness. Please help me acknowledge this remarkable young woman, Gracie Keller.